Alright friends, so let us start this topic today. We are gonna cover website how we are gonna make a website and do optimization of it so that in search engine, especially Google, it comes onto the top organic listings. Now this is what we are gonna cover today. This topic was already started in the last session. It will take 3 sessions at least to get completed. Now, since many of you are joining it for the first time, it is good for me to do a little recap so that you have a good continuation and understanding out of it. This is theoretical part, but I'll concentrate more on a practical running today. I've decided not to touch the theoretical aspect at all, but since there are many new attendees today, I'll do a quick recap. In the same batch, this batch was started. It's already a fifth session for the batch, so there were 4 sessions that are already passed. In the first 3 sessions, we have done moreover how to do a communication part of it, of digital marketing, which included Facebook promotions, YouTube promotions, and email marketing. The idea behind it was, let's do a promotion section first and then comes into the core development of the product like website. That way you get a little confidence into the course, as well as you know how and what are the prime responsibilities of a digital marketer and how you're able to tackle the whatever objective you're going to get or brief you're going to get to do a campaign. So that was the basic idea and why we do why we have done that. But anyways, I won't these way. This is something which I discussed, that what kind of different websites are there. It can be a content static website. There can be a blog oriented website. There can be an e-commerce oriented website. So we're gonna start with simple. We're gonna start with how to make a blog oriented website so that you know at least you know how the changes of the pages and manipulation can be done. This is how we're gonna start it, and then we're gonna redesign it. We're gonna put a little images, background images, and all that. And this is how we're gonna do it. If you wanna develop any website in a core, the developer could help you out in that. But since you and me doesn't know the coding part of it, there are few tools which are called CMS, which are content management systems, available. With the use of that, we can make a website very very fast, actually real time, and we can also make it quite a handy website. But if you want a very very good product which have many features into it and different features which are even not existing sometimes, then of course the developer is gonna help you out in that, right? These are 2 questions. Since many of you are joining for the first time, I'd like to share it with you. The attendees who are or the trainees who are already into the batch have experience there. This is something which I share with you so that you know what are expectations of the industry of the employers once they look for digital marketers, or even the clients if you are working as a digital marketing agency. They have a brief idea of what ultimately they want out of their product, that it should grow to a level where they can have 100,000 users in 24 weeks, or let's say they have 5 crores or 2 crores or 1 crore in total as a marketing budget, and they like to see you how you plan it and how you execute it. So marketing, whatever we are going to learn in these courses, the tool running is only 20-30% of the job that you know how to do, but you should know what to do. And this is something which nobody can teach you very straight. I mean, different scenarios will have different approaches. Even the same scenario will have different approaches. So if we have one common problem, right now we are 19 people who are talking to each other. We could have 19 or even 34, even 70 different ideas with us, right? And so it's all on it's more of a 70% of the brain when it comes to marketing, which people underestimate. So your idea should, my suggestion to you should is that just whatever you're gonna learn, just do a good dry run of it, implement it somehow. The more you practice, the more you learn, and the more you practice, you get to know the more scenarios, difficult scenarios and challenges which would come in between. If you do not practice and see that whatever you learned, it's only a tool running. So it should not only limited to tool running. I also try to discuss a little more of what is happening real time market, and so that you get the idea, and we can do a little brainstorming as well. So you get to know more of that 70% also in the course. Anyways, it is not important as such. I guess these are few. Anyway, this is my website's creatives. This is I've used to let you know what is the difference between creative and media. People may get bored because the attendees who started this batch get to know this almost 3 or 4 times. But many of you are for the first time. So does everybody know over here? We are 21, 22 people, including me. So everybody over here does know what is in marketing or in digital marketing. What do we call a media and what do we call a creative in an ad? Chirag said yes. Chirag, you must be knowing, right? Naveen, hi Naveen. Preeti says yes. Yeah, Preeti, Achalata, Chirag, Shubham, you guys must be knowing. Yes, I know. What about others? What about who have come for the first time? Does it know in advertisement and marketing what is media and what is creative? I'm sorry guys, Achalata and all. I'm sorry, I'm just taking a minute on to this. You guys know. Jeevan doesn't know that. But who else doesn't know that? Please be outspoken. Don't. We have to make this an interactive session. So, yeah, Mani says no. Balaji says no. Yeah, it is. So, I was expecting it. Whosoever is joining for the first time probably would not be knowing it. But I'll let you know what it is in just a. Harshika is saying no. Alright, I'll just let you know. Alright, Harshika and Manish and Jeevan and Balaji, just let me know what any brand and any advertisement, what you saw and where did you saw it? What did you last remember of any promotion? Maybe online, offline, outdoor, TV, print, whatever. Where have you seen that? What was the brand name? Just name it. Harshika, Balaji, Manish, Jeevan. I'm sorry guys, I'm taking a couple more minutes. Whosoever knows it, just bear with me, but cannot hear anything. I guess everybody else can hear and not attendee, so you can just housing.com. So Shubham is saying that housing.com, where in which media platform, where have you seen it? I mean, have you seen it on a TV? Have you seen it on a print? Was it an online ad you saw? All right, Balaji, so what is the last brand you remember that you saw an ad of? Ad, commercial, what you saw, and where did you see it? I mean, did you see it on a TV? Amway, where Amway, Harshika, where have you seen that? All right, so this is good. Prop Tigers ad, Karthikeyan. All right, I'm picking up example or illustration of what Karthikeyan has seen. So you guys have seen Prop Tiger ad, a banner ad on a YouTube. Now YouTube is a media right now in a ad language, in a ad terminology and lingo. YouTube becomes a host where an ad is shown. And in Prop Tiger ad, Karthikeyan, what was there? I mean, was there a model or what? So if there is a model which is used and whatever the ad is, yeah, that is called creative. So let's say if I see a Hema Malini ad of a Kent RO, that Kent RO, how it has been shown, what are the copies used, was it a blue color used more or a white color used more, is she wearing a sari or is she wearing a suit, whosoever decides it is a creative agency that does that. So making an ad can be of a TV commercial. Yeah, just hold on with the answer. I'm just letting you know what is creative and media. Now that is a creative. That is called a creative. And wherever it is hosted, on a TV channel, on a newspaper print, or on a magazine, or an online channel, that is called a media. So creative is making a site. If I see this ad is right now, which you can see on a screen. It's womanears.com ad. Now this ad is a creative which is made. If I place it on a Facebook, now Facebook becomes a media for it. So I have to decide which media I have to run an ad, and I also have to give my input as a digital marketer of how to make a ad. So I also have to give a thought about making how to make a creative, and you could see why these colors are used what are used, and you could see why this font is used what is used, because if I would have used a more block kind of font, it would have not appealed for a woman audience. So that was the reason it was used that way, right? Why are logos used where it is used, and all that and all that. Why such a ratio? Why not any other ratio, aspect ratio and all that? I don't know how many of you now know aspect ratio, but I guess many of you also know that, right? So I'm just moving on to the subject. Otherwise, I'll just cover these creative topics on any other session. But this is what was discussed. All right, this is what I always say, that learning any course, including this, you should not, like, if you learn finance, you should not become an accountant but a financier. And if you learn digital marketer, you should know not only know how to run a tool, but you should know what to do at which stage of a brand cycle. Then what you have discussed on the last session, we have started making websites. Now to make a website, there are two aspects. You should have a domain name, and you should also have a web hosting place. Once you are done with that, you could install WordPress into your web hosting space, and you can start creating a website. So there are 2-3 plans which are available with WordPress. The basic plan is free, so you can make a free website in one way or the other. Once you're logged in into it, I think everybody of you who is gonna subscribe will be given one free website from DMP, Digital Marketing Pathshala. This is what I've been told. Now since you'll be getting this, you'll get to this page, what you can see right now, and then you can just practice on how to do it. Yes, Manish, in fact, now if you sometimes you do not need how to install WordPress, but it is very easy. Suppose you have taken I can't run it right now, but I can just let you know theoretically how to do it. Yes, I'm just letting you know. Manish, just hold on to the horses. You'll get the answers of everything, right? First, you take a domain name, then you move on to the next space of, let's say you go to any hosting website. Let's say you go to hostgator.com. I'll also give you another example. Now you select your plan and you buy a hosting space. Once you buy that, you'll get a cPanel, a control panel. Once you get a control panel, in that you can go to a subsection of installing third party services. Once you go that, you can just click onto WordPress and it will be getting installed to the domain you have linked with. Alright, I'm just holding for Jeevan to answer. Jeevan is asking, sir, which one mode would you suggest for best understanding online and offline? I didn't get your answer fully. Which one more would you suggest for the best understanding, online or offline? I didn't get you what exactly you want to ask. Can you just repeat in any other way? Manish, just for your knowledge and others, now you can just directly go to WordPress and have this site. Even this is possible. So you can even go to a leasing companies who are offering like GoDaddy and all, who are or BigRock and all, who are offering domain names, and then you go to a web hosting service provider like HostGator and buy a hosting space. Rather than doing that, you can even go directly to WordPress and buy a complete package in $13, $18, around that one is. Or you can also go to GoDaddy and they also provide the same kind of package in 1000 rupees or something like that. So you'll ultimately directly land into their page. All right, I'll hold on for answering the questions I've been put to. As Dion is saying, like online class or offline class, which mode of education would be preferred for better understanding? By which mode you want to know that, an offline way of learning it onto the class or an online session like this? This is what you're asking. All right, with DMP, I guess DMP is offering 3-4 courses. This is the best course, I guess, because it will cover all the aspects. It have 12 sessions into it, and online will make more sense, I guess, rather than offline somehow, because you have a liberty of sitting down anywhere. The trainers like me can also help you out in that. So rather than going for an offline session, online session makes sense. And you get also, I guess, DMP also gives you a liberty of logging into various different training. Suppose I'm covering a different topic and another trainer is covering a different topic. So they give you a liberty of switching also. So you can retain to my batch. You can also learn a few topics from the other batches. So this is what I could say, that DMP is offering best right now, and that too at a very cheaper cost. I've been put to many questions, I'm answering one by one. I've been asked to share the contact number. This is my contact number and this is my name. So do not get confused with Nikhil Batla. He's the main guy behind DMP, but I'm a trainer only over here. No, they're not different. It's only that you get to sit on an offline session, whereas this is an online session. Alright, course inside digital marketing. Alright, Manish, so and others. Yeah, Chirag, let's come to the topic now. Once you do that, you come onto the dashboard. Now, in dashboard, this is something which we have covered in last, but since there are many new guys, I'm just covering it quickly. In dashboard, you could see that there are various boxes which you could see. At a glance, you get to look onto the left of what is happening to it. Yes, Manish. Please ask quickly. Manish, I have to take any hosting website which I haven't bought it right now, right? I've been telling you that once you log into WordPress, you can directly buy it. Once you buy it, you directly land to the WordPress thing. Or what you could do is, like for example, like this. You go to GoDaddy or any other provider who is offering this. Sorry. Yeah, see, You can download it, but you can download it from a window which could offer you to install it. This is what I'm saying. Either you go to GoDaddy, buy a domain name to whatever address you want to have it, and then you can go to the hosting and directly go to WordPress hosting product. That way you directly get that. If in case you don't want to buy this kind of product, you have to buy a domain name by going into the domains. You buy a domain from them, then you go to a web hosting provider where a web your website will be hosted. You buy that product, like for example this. Once you buy that, you'll get a control panel access, a username and a password. Since I'm not very keen of buying this way, but I'm letting you know how it is done if in case you're not directly buying a WordPress hosting plan. So you buy a web hosting space with them. Once you buy that, you get a cPanel, a control panel. Once you get a control panel with a username and password, once you get into it, you'll get a button, a tab, where it will be seen that you can install third-party CMSs. Once you click on that, there will be many CMSs coming onto it, including WordPress. Once you click WordPress, you can have the WordPress installed into that space for your website. Is it okay? It is not a rocket science. Why don't you just buy a web hosting space and practice it? If in case you don't do that, you'll not be able to do it. Yeah, because downloading WordPress has to have some kind of hosting space where it will be run and linked with a domain name so that you can see it, whatever changes you are doing in a WordPress. Now you got it. Yeah, Manish. Quickly answer, even others are waiting, Manish. We can move that straight away. Anyways, let's go on. Manish will answer in a minute. So you get a, this is how you get to know, this is how you get a back panel where you can make the changes. You can directly install few themes and then upload the data on the dummy data. But rather than doing so, I'll prefer to start with a very basic theme, a default theme, which comes with the WordPress. And we'll go step by step. First, we'll learn how to do a little changes in a blog. This very theme 2016 is limited to how a good blog is made. Then we'll start making pages. Then we'll start adding few forms like contact form and all that. And then we'll progressively put few images, background and all that, and try to make a website. So we learn to make a building brick by brick. How to add a post. Now, simultaneously, we'll be keep on looking onto how the front end is there. Now, this is the back end you can see, and this is the front end of the site. This is something which I made for to let you know the learning. There is a link, Harshika, where in which you can get all the videos of DMP. The access of which, however, will be different compared to people who have already subscribed it or onto the demo. This is the link. Yeah. Anyways, you can just see this is the front end of the site, nikhilgurav.com, and this is name, header image, which you call a banner sometimes. I'll let you know how this banner can be brought or not. These are the navigation bar, and these are the posts, a blog. You can see this is a blog which comes by default, but let us, in the last session we have covered this, but very quickly I'm gonna cover how to make a new blog since many of you are new over here. So you go to blog section and then you can edit even the existing one, or you can go and click on to the add new. You just click on to the add new and let's say My blog is name it Learning Digital Marketing, and you can just write whatever content you want to write. So I'm just writing down content, right? In this content, you can also have few backlinks. These are the, I'll just let you know how to go about it. Well, let's say this is your first session. Hopefully you enjoy it. So let's say you can write n number of words into it, and let's say you have written a good article onto the subject you want to write. Once you're done that, you can also, like, using a MS Word, you can highlight a few like this, bold or italics. You can add a backlink over here like this and put a URL. Let's say you put a URL to this and add a link. What will happen is, once you'll publish it and this will come onto the main website, if you click onto this, you'll get to the landing page or whatever link you have placed it over here. So that thing, you can do it by doing it over here. You can move, right? Once you do that, you would see that whatever blog you have written, you can just place it onto any of the categories over here. So let's say I want to put this ad, this blog under marketing training and digital marketing category, I can do that. Alright, let's say I want to add another category onto it. So you can add a new category, let's say DMP. So you have added a new category, and you could decide that this article should be under, or this new category should be under which parent. It can be a different without any parent, or it can be with a parent. Parent means that this will be a subcategory of a parent category. Let's have decided that DMP should be a subcategory of a marketing training category. I've done that. And then you can also connect it with various tags. The reason why we do it, why we connect with various tags, is so that if somebody search for it, you could connect it with one keyword, one summary word, and then you get to know onto the top of the listing. So if somebody search with that name, your article should come onto the top for them to access. Let's say the tags which I'm connecting is digital marketing, then let's say another tag, DMP, right? Something like that. So you can just add on like that. Now, here is the publishing window. In this, you could see that you have an option of putting this blog, this article, into various subcategories. Either you can make it a normal public so that anybody can see it to it once they log into your website, or you can also make it password protected. So if you make it a password protected, only the people who are having that password have to punch that password into it, and then only they'll be able to have it. So you can just write down the password, and then once they log into it, they have to punch that password, and then only they'll be able to see it, right? And you also have a liberty of putting a publishing date into it. You can do it a little backward, and you can also put a forwarding date. So it will be published on that date and time what you're done. So right now, let's say I want to write an article of, let's say, on 26 January. And right now it is coming into my mind, I just written it. And I want it to be published only on 25th night. So I can just predate it, and it will be published on that particular date and time what I've put. Right now, I'm deciding to put it immediately so that you can at least see it on the website how it comes. So let us click on publish. And once you go onto the back panel, once you go onto the all posts, we could see that this blog has come into the picture. And let us see if it is there onto the website. You could see that on the website it has come. So if you click that, this is how it has come. We can also put images into it. This I'll let you know once we do pages, because we are going to cover pages today. The way for putting an image is onto a blog or on a page is same. So I'll do that into my next thing which I'm discussing, right? So everything clear till here. Diti, Rishikan, Sangeeta, Shubham, Mukesh, especially the new attendees, Azan, Ashalataya. Anybody who has any doubt till here? Manish, are you clear till here? MK? Alright. Now, what we have discussed is we have written an article, we have written a blog, and we have put that into a category where we want that article to represent. Like if you see it over here, over here, you could see that it is under this category. Now if you want to make a category separately, this is the window to go about it. You just click on to categories and you could see that your website has these categories right now. These categories, right? And if I want to add a new category, I can just add it by clicking here. Let's say my new category is, just name one category which I should add. Name anything. SEO. So let's search engine optimization. I can write it this way. Slug is basically a URL. So you can just leave it empty also. The machine will, the system will automatically put a URL for it. And then you can just write a description of whatever you want to write. And then all you have to do is click onto category. And you could see that this category has come. Once we put and write down any article and link it under this category, there the count will come over here. 1, 2, and however it has connected it. Yeah, Rishikant, we have picked it one. That was just for the example. So let's ignore all this right now. All right. Now let us go to the existing article and try to put any image into it. So let's say that was the last article we had done. So you'll learn to know how to edit it. Let's say you have written one article and then once you read it, you find that there is little editing you want to do it and you want to make it better. So there are two windows where you can do it. You can click on to the edit or quick edit. Quick edit allows you to do, all right, MK wants the categories to be explained. All right. Category is basically, especially it is used under the page or under the website which is blog oriented website. So under blog, because since you have been publishing various articles into it, it is better for the user to have a clear indexing into it. So if I as a nikhilgrover.com want to talk about various topics, I want to talk about digital marketing, I want to talk about marketing, I want to talk about TV marketing, I also want to talk about some social orientations, I want to talk about traffic and all that. So one way of making that site could be that every article should be published one under other. So this is a part of it, Sukhvinder. A blogging site is also creating a website, right? So it's a part of it. Anyways, so once you do that, if you're making a website which is blog oriented website, and you are putting various articles under it, Manish have explained it, and right now we're learning how to make the website, right? I've already explained it. Yeah, once we know how to manage it, automatically it will be represented to a making website. This is not a developer's class, right? It's a digital marketing course. So if you want to know how to code a website, I think this is the wrong subject you are logged in into it. Anyways, I've been asked a question on how to make a how to I mean I have to explain about categories. Let's say you are onto a blogging and an article based website, and you wanted to write different articles or publish different articles. The one way of doing about it is whatever new you write will go under of what you have earlier written. Now, since you are doing that, there can be various articles onto the different subjects simultaneously lagging and stacking one below other. So the ideal way of doing is that you make some categories and put it under whatever new you are writing, put it under those categories. So it is like making subfolders on an Outlook. So you need not to go back to the whole inbox to search of whatever mail has come. So it is just a systematic way of doing it. It even helps in search engine optimization. Because you have been publishing it under different different categories, if a third person looks for that kind of category, it helps the search engine optimization to put your article under the category which has been searched for, to put it onto the top of the organic listings. So that is why it is. Yeah, so you have to put it under certain category. This is something which is advisable. So what you can do is you can make a category and link it to the article to those categories. Anode is saying please unmute. You can write it down whatever you want to write to me on the chat. Right, and then you can go to edit. This is how we are going to see how to put an image into it. And let's say I've been writing article over here and I want to put an image into it. So all I have to do is Let's say I've written another line. Then we'll learn how to put different banners. And let's say you want to put an image just above the sentence, right? So what you do is just click over here, we go to add media, this media library will display all the images which you have earlier put, and you can also go to upload images and select a particular file or image what you want to put it over here. You can just click on that and select the images. Let's have selected this image and you insert it. You can also link it to a URL, so I can just link it to dmppathshala.com. Updated. Yes, you can get the video, I hope. Now let us see if it has come here. We'll refresh this. See, this is the image. If I click onto it, I guess the URL name probably would have been problem, but it landed, it will land to the whatever landing page we have written over there, right? So everybody clear till here? Right. Now this is about while making a website how you go about putting a blog. Now let's say you want to put a different email, a different page into it. So a website can be a combination of blogs and pages, or it can be only page oriented website. So this is how we're going to learn how to make pages into it. We go to pages. You can either edit the earlier page or you can add a new page. Let's say I want to name it as gallery, or let's say just name the name of the page. Any name, I'll put that. I guess it depends on the theme, Chirag, of how many you can add n number of pages, but then you have to decide how many pages you want to put in onto the navigation bar. So it will have a limited access to it. Some themes will have 5 to 10, some themes may have even more than that. So I've inside home. Home. And let's let's say into home, once somebody clicks on to home, you want the image or let's say a basic write up to display. So every time somebody opens that, you want it to display a few images. So you have to put image into it. I don't know if this will come. This is only a reference image, so you can just put whatever image you want to put. And you want to write welcome to my world. And you want to put it in order three, I'll let you know the navigation bar, it will come on to the third place. And you publish it. I've been asked few questions, I'm answering one by one. What is the difference between post and a page? Both will have a heading, post and a page. Post is basically a blog, an article, where you can write down an article. A page is basically a static page, where you will not have various subcategories and categories kind of thing, and you can display it anything. You can put an image into a web, into a page, you can put a text, but it will not be under various categories. So it will have its standalone presence. So that is called a page. Whereas post is where it will be linked to various subcategories. So you write down an article and you just link it to any category. So you can put various posts under one header. So that is the basic difference between a post and a page. A page will have its separate identity, whereas post will be under some category, or it will be part of a group in that article. So this is the difference between post and a page. Order, Chirag, is it will depend on which page we are. Suppose we are putting a order to a navigation bar, so it will be like where you want the particular thing which you have written onto which order. And suppose you're putting a post, then you can put it in order under this category that you wanted post to be on second or third into the on this. Same way for the categories. If you're on the deciding category pages, then you can decide which order the category should come. So whatever you write in an order, it will be, yeah, that way it should be going. So this is how you do a page making, which is very easy. You can also practice it. Let us go about putting in form. Form is basically like you want some information to be received at your end. It can be a contact form, or it can be, let's say you want to put a quotation. So you want whosoever comes as a visitor should spare away few details, and then in return you give some information. So let's say we are doing a contact form. So you can just make a new form, or these are the forms which come by default. So you can add a new form. Let's say I want a first name. First, I guess I have to fill like the post over here. Go to forms, you go to all forms, okay, this is already coming. Wait, I guess there's a little confusion over here. No, I have to first select. Let's say I form put it like form test. First, I have to name it. Once I name it, I'll get to have a window where I can put the templates or whatever I want to put. Sorry, the internet is, I guess, a little slow. The internet is a little slow. I'll just refresh it. Let us stop it because it is taking away too long. And then refresh it. Sorry guys, it's taking a little long. I don't know why. So sorry guys, there is some problem in the internet, it is just going a little slow. Anyway, we are about to close Vanna. Let's take a break for 5 minutes and then I'll come back. In the meanwhile, I'll also check what is happening to the internet. All right, friends. Yeah, just have a break for 5 minutes and figure it out what is happening to the internet.
अरे यार 5 मिनट का ब्रेक है, अब तो बात कर सकता हूँ ना। Hi friends, so it's good to go again. Let us resume the session. It has started working. Let's see. So everybody here, shall we start it again? Hi. So instead of, there are two ways to go about it, putting a form, that you make a form and then you connect it to the place where you want to place it. This is going a little slow, so let us do one thing. Let us pick a post where we'll put up this form. I'm so sorry, this is, I don't know why this suddenly gone so slow. Internet is coming, but not with the proper speed somehow. I'm so sorry, Vincent. Suddenly the system has gone, I mean the internet has gone really slow. It's not reacting. Yeah, Chirag, please ask me. Yeah, meanwhile, why don't you just put up few questions in between? Convert what? Oh, it is very easy. You. You can just save it into. Yes, so what you do is you write down various email addresses over here. Like this, especially if you're using 2010 or 7 Office, just need to go to save as CSV format, rename the file. And save of whatever location you want to save. Let's say you want to save it on desktop. Save it. It'll ask for the conversion, say OK, say yes. You'll have it. You'll also have a Excel file, so you'll have both the comments. I'm so sorry, friend. This has somehow gone very slow and is not reacting. Also, I've also checked my modem, it is working very fine. I don't know what is happening. I guess the internet has suddenly gone slow. Alright, so at least I started working again. Let's see how it goes. In the meanwhile, Chirag has asked cost for sending emails. Zero. You can send it free. Once you have done the email marketing section, we have discussed that there are few websites which are providing free services. And we have used one of those services. It was filled. Yeah, MailChimp is something which we have discussed. So in MailChimp, we can do it for free. So you have used any other service, right? Or you have used MailChimp only? I guess let's discuss this after this session, Chirag, on the subject which is not related to today's topic. Everybody is waiting for it to discuss. Let's discuss whatever we want to after that. So what you do is, let's say you make a new thing over here. It is not coming to the post. I don't know, I guess there is some problem with the Ninja Form section which they have, because it's not getting uploaded. So how it happens is basically, I'll explain it afterwards also, but how it happens is you name it. Once you name it, you can put the sections. You put the section first name, last name, the message, email ID, whatever information you want. And then it displays onto the page where people can feel it. Feed the thing and you'll get to see it onto the submission sections. But since it is not working, let's not waste our time. Two forms only. I guess there is some problem with the Ninja Forms over here. There is one plugin, Ninja Form. This allows this in the theme, but this is somehow not getting up to the mark. So let's discuss another topic which I've thought I'll cover after forms. First, I'll cover this and then I'll cover the forms then. So let us first come to the appearance part. Now, what we have discussed so far is we have discussed how to put a blog, we have discussed how to put a page and how to add a new page. Then we were to discuss forms, but unfortunately the form section is not working fine. I'll just recheck afterwards what is the case. And after that, now let's work on to the feel, look and feel of the website. To check the look and feel of the website, yeah, we are discussing layout elements right now. First, you need to go to the appearance section. Okay, you are asking, I guess, Sangeeta, from the one of the tabs in this, right? Okay, layout elements and HR. This I have to check because I haven't used it. No, I haven't used it, so I have no idea what is this HR is for. I'll just recheck and let you know. Where I made a very basic form where I've used only, you know, these text box details and all that. So once we'll run that, I'll let you know. Anyways, form will cover it afterwards also because it is not working fine. So in appearance section, you have all this. There are various themes which right now we are on this theme. We can also select other themes. Like for example, these themes, these are free themes. If in case you want to check out new theme, you just need to click on add new and you can select it. Every theme will have its limitations. Some themes will be good for making good create pages. Some themes will be good for blogs and all that. So what we are doing right now is we are trying to manipulate the basic theme and see at what best level we can take it, and then we'll try to bring it the same concept onto the various themes. The theme you can change it anytime, and your data will be converted into that theme and your website will be converted in that theme which you select. There are also on the theme section, I want to let you know that there are also paid themes which are available. So there are various sites who offer you paid themes that you can buy it. Can you please suggest some site for free images? Yeah, Themify is good actually. I've tried to have one theme from Themify, but then I've ignored it. But Themify is good for themes. Images, Shutterstock is best. For all my purposes, I frankly use Shutterstock. And if you're going with Indian origin, Chirag, he is asking for images and not for themes. So, For Indian images, you can prefer Image Bazaar, but otherwise, Shutterstock is best. All right, I'll just write down. Shutterstock.com. Here you can have very good images. All right, let us discuss this. So this is how you select theme, or whatever theme you are, you can just customize it onto the appearance part. So whatever changes you start doing over here, it will be represented over here. So let us start with header image. Let's say you do not have any image in the theme right now. So this particular theme suggests to put a header image, or what you call a banner image, of a size aspect ratio of 1200 by 280 width into height. So does we know what is 1200 by 200 aspect ratio pixels? I mean, do we know what is aspect ratio, so that everybody is clear? I guess half of you knows, but does everybody know that? What does we mean by 1200 pixels by 200 pixels or 280 pixels? If I say an image should be of, let's say, 512 by 512 pixels, what does that mean? No sir, I'm getting no sir. Does everybody else know? NK, Mukesh, Subin, yeah, Chirag, I've told it, but I'm just confirming it from everyone else. So it is basically the width and height of the size. Sangeeta doesn't know that. I'll just let you know, Sangeeta, what it is. Just cons all right. For all who doesn't know, including Harshika and everybody else, I'll just let you know. An image will always have a size of it, you know, a width-wise and height-wise. So this is nothing but aspect ratio is basically the image size. So it has to be under certain size, and this recommends it to be in a size of 1200 pixels by 280 pixels, so that it has the best fit on the page. What we do. Same way, if you put let's say a banner image of your Facebook profile or of your YouTube channel, or any image will have its size. So once you do that, they'll recommend you that it should be of this and this size, so that it has the best impact. Otherwise, you'll have a cut area, or your picture can fall short. So in order to have that size, what automatic system does is it recreates the image to that size. And sometimes if the image is of low resolution, will get blurred if the size is smaller and the host size is bigger. So let's say I add a new image over here. So what you are right now doing is you're putting a banner image. So just click on that. I'm so sorry, the internet has suddenly got very slow. So you can upload it from here. This image I've already put, so I'll pick up a new image. Let's search for a new image because I do not have enough size available with me. Let's say I want an banner image. This is only for reference purpose. Do not use it that way what I'm using. Create your own image or buy it from a site like Shutterstock and all that. Make the changes and then put it. This is only for the reference purpose. So 1200 by 280. Image section. Let's say I pick this. Save this image. And then I go back to the window and browse for it. Get to have this window, this image. I've uploaded it. Now it is getting uploading. since it is getting uploaded. Now it is uploaded. Well, if the size is, let's say, bigger or whatever image you have done, it also gives you permission to crop it. You can also put a title, the name, caption, and all that. And let's you select it. Now it has come to the cropping window. So it, since we have only taken 1200 by 280 pixels, we need not to crop it further. But suppose you have a bigger image or something like that, so it also gives you an option of cropping it. So what will happen is the selected area will be remained, the rest area will be deleted. So since we have same size, we'll skip cropping. And what it is doing right now is uploading it here. I'm sorry, the system is slow. Okay, the size was slow, not the exact size. So that is why it's come slow. So what we can do, if in case it allows you, but it doesn't allow us this. But anyways, I'll recommend you to take the particular size. Let's see if we can do it on the cropping kind of thing. It doesn't give us the permission to do that. But anyways, I'll recommend to make us image of that particular size and then only put it. So let's say if I want to select this, this was of a particular size, 1200 by 280. So it will come fully over here. You can also select multiple images and put it on to the random upload headers. So what will happen is, if you do it this way, random upload header, this is on this particular theme. There will be few themes in which you can run a slider, so it will run left to right kind of thing. But in this theme, you can put different images, banner images or header images, and every time it is getting uploaded into any system throughout the world, it will randomly pick the image to display out of all the images you have selected. So we can also test it if in case it is working that way. So you log into the site. Right now it is coming this. Let's say I'm refreshing if it comes different. Now it is coming same. You can just log into your, in case saying voice is breaking. Is the voice breaking at the other end too? Because Rishikant, right now I can't, but I'll just look for it and I'll do it in the next session. Because even when I searched, I didn't get it. So I was just looking for it in WordPress theme, which is the slide which I can take for this purpose. Which theme I can take for this purpose. So I'll just pick it up because it is not available, I guess, on a free kind of thing. We have to pay for it. I'll just look for that thing, I'll buy it, and then I'll let you know. I'll try to do it once I pick the e-commerce one. If in case you guys want an e-commerce kind of site making session, then I'll do that, because that way we'll also get to learn more about more than a static website. Yeah. Chirag, everybody is saying yes. So what we do is, we'll just hold on this session of e-commerce session, e-commerce website making. We'll buy a theme and then we'll run that on that particular day. And that time I'll buy a theme which will have a multiple slider into it. We all need to buy it then, right? NK saying video lag. I guess NK, this could be, I don't know if it is the video lag and voice problem is coming with the other, at the other end as well, but it could be also because my internet has suddenly gone a little slow, this Airtel connection. I have no idea, and to do it real time it will be, yeah. So just bear with me for this session at least now. All right, so this is how you do the header image kind of thing. Then you can also put an icon image
into it. Where instead of this, there will be always an icon image coming over here. This is a blog oriented kind of theme, so that is why the facilities which you are getting is related to that. So it, the image which it recommend is 512 by 512, so you can just pick an image and upload it, right? Then you go to making changes on the colors. So you can change the background color. There are few selected colors. You can also go over here and change it. So let's say I select, let's say yellow. So the background part will get a yellow color. You can also put a different color into it. Let's say I put this, or let's say I put this or this. So you can just put whatever color you want. Let's say I put this, right? Then a page background color is basically the main page which is coming white right now, and I, let's say I want it little gray, so it has gone a little gray, and I want, let's say, a little darker, so I've done little darker. Then let's say I want a link color, wherever link displays this color, and this is okay. Let's say I want a text color rather than black, I want, let's say, little grayish, so it'll become grayish, yeah. Or let's say I want a little reddish, so it'll become onto the red tone. So I can just decide upon it what exactly I want. And this was the for the primary text. This is for the secondary text. Like Michael Grover written over here is with the primary text, and the tagline below it is a secondary text, so I can do this. And I can also save and publish it. Mukesh has asked a question. Mukesh, your header name as in this. I guess it would be possible. I'll just check it out. Let us hold it. Once we do it, I'll just check it out and let you know. Right now, let's work on a theme. Are logos put using icon image option? Yes. This 512 wala thing. This is how you put a logo, Sangeeta. I'll try to pick a 512 by 512 image and display it to you. Image 512 into 512 pixels, but do not use it this way because it will have a copyright issue. I'll just do it for a demonstration right now, and then I'll remove it. I recommend not to put in your website or your functionality, right? It. So in site identity you go and select the site icon, you upload the file, is getting uploaded. Then you select it. Let us refresh it. No, it is not that. The rest of the changes had come, but not this. There's also no display here. It has to come as a browser icon over here. Oh, no, it is coming as a browser icon. So yes, you can see that this image is coming as a browser icon. Yes, it has already come. Now, in order to have an image over here as an Adesen fixed logo, then the template must be supporting to it. I guess this template may not have been supporting to it. Once we pick an e-commerce kind of theme, there we'll practice all this, because I'll try to buy a good theme, and then we can do that. These free themes and logger-in themes won't allow that kind of thing. Yeah, Sangeeta, okay. Everybody else, so clear till here how to bring a header image and different images into website, how to change the color, the background, and all that. We can also put a background image. Background images, as in right now what green color is there, so you can put a background image. Let's say we put this image. This is a background image. So you just choose it. Now it is up to you how to use it. You can make it a tile kind of thing. You can put the tile horizontally, vertically. Position the thing by a scroller fix. Scroller fix means that suppose this is a big image, but suppose you have picked a background image where you have put it on a fix. So what will happen is, if your website has a longer length, you just scroll it down, the background image will be fixed, and it won't scroll down with the website. It will be fixed to a limit or whatever the size is. If you have put this onto the scroll, it will continue and will brought in a loop. So this is how you can do it on a background image. NK saying, yeah, but we shifted from page to WordPress. I didn't get you. We are into the WordPress admin panel. I've opened the website into this, a different tab. Now this is the admin panel. I'll let you know. I guess there is some confusion. First we save this. Are you asking this, how we get into this, NK? Okay. This is the dashboard of the WordPress. There are different sections. We went into appearance. In appearance, there are sub themes. We went into customize. Once we get into customize, we reaches to this, where we can customize the look and feel of the website. We are working on different aspects right now. First, we were working on an header image. We have changed the header image. Then we have worked on color themes. I guess you were into with us when we are discussing that. So clear till here, right? How we have changed different colors, the background color, the text color, right? How we have put a header image. NK and others. Then how we have changed the background image. And now the menu. This theme gives us permission to two main menu. One is this one, or you can log on to the site and see this, the navigation bar wala menu, main menu, and this one, the social media menu, which is coming beneath. So how we do is we go to main menu, and you could see that there are two pages which has been reflected right now. So you can add items into it. Let's say I want to add another page into it. So first, how to go about it? These are the pages which are already we have made going into the page section. So that this probably should be one of the pages which are just made home. I guess this, because we have also linked it. So let's say this was the page which we have made. So what you have to do is, suppose you want, now this is the existing website, and you want another page to come over here on the navigation bar. So the first thing which you have to do is you have to make the page. So what you do is, you basically, I'll come back over here again, I'll display you how to go about step by step. The very first thing which you do is, you go to the pages section and add new page. So you make a new page. Let's say this is the page which we have made. We have made a new page called home, for example. Then what we do is, we go to the appearance section. We go to customize. We go to menu. We go to this main menu section, and then we add item into it. We can add all these items. Let's say we want to add this new page, and we add this, so it will come over here. And while making the page, you can make the page like putting images, putting a text, or whatever you want to do that, and then you save it. Once you save it, you could see, we'll refresh it and we'll see if it has come. So we'll see that it has come, and you could also see that once we have refreshed, it has randomly picked the another banner which we have put. So while uploading the website at different ends, it will randomly pick the image it will as a header image. In the home section, and now it has put a different image randomly. This has picked the same stuff which I put it on IMI myself about a solar page. Right? So this is how you do. Everybody clear till here? Yeah. You go to this, sorry. Yeah, what you do is, you basically go to this, and suppose you want this particular home to be, let's say, on the first position. You just pick it up and you put it on the first place. Now what has come? Home has come onto the first, I myself has come to the second, and contact. Let's say you want to put contact onto the second and this thing on the third. So what you do is, okay, it has somehow made this as the subcategory, but I do not want this. So you want this. You can also make it as its sub page. So comment is coming as a sub page. That we don't want that, we want it to be a separate page. We have done that. Let's save and publish. Yeah, we just have to drag it. And you can also make sub pages, now it happens. Like for example, you make a services wala page, and in services you are offering, let's say, different services, prototype services, final build services, or whatever business you are doing. So you make different services, or you make a category page and you put, let's say, apparels as one category, shoes as one category, and all that. So you can also, let's say, let's assume that wherever it is written as, let's say, the main category, I myself, and it is a shoe category. So I can just make it as a subcategory like this. So what will happen is, over here it will come as a main service, and beneath it will come as sub the name of the different subcategories, right? So now you can see that home has come onto the first. Got it? Everybody got it? So we know how to make the look and changes on the look and feel, how to put a header image. This is mostly drag and drop, and you know, a very easy admin panel. Yeah, there was little confusion with amongst others in between, where they were expecting a different way of how to make a website. In this course, we could only teach you how, or let you know how to use a CMS and make a website. Creating a website altogether with a coding will have a different course altogether. So it is not a web development course. It is basically using a CMS and making a site, because the idea is to represent you a digital marketing aspect, where creating a simple website with a web, you know, with an admin panel or with a CMS will make sense of creating a product, not making a website, right? But anyways, any questions so far? Now onto this, we are left with two, three things. First, we have to pick an e-commerce version of it, a search engine optimization using different widgets. Yeah, it will help you, because even if, let's say, on you join a brand, or you're working for as an agency, or you're working as a digital marketing. Sangeeta has actually raised a good point, and this is something I just take a minute and want to discuss. As a digital marketer, if you join a company, the site will be anyways, if in case it's a robust product, will be developed by a developer or a team of developer or an IT team. And they'll make the website based on your inputs or inputs prior to the person who has joined you. And they'll make the website and they'll give it to you with the CMS. Working on a CMS will help you understand what can be done on a website and how to do it. So once you do that, you'll be able to manage it, because you, of course, you cannot make the changes on the development part. For that, you need to contact the IT team, IT department of your company. But whosoever makes a website, even a developer makes a website, has to make a CMS so that, you know, the executioner can execute it. So this is the part of the curriculum, not the coding part of it. So everybody understood till here? All right, social menu is left. Sorry. Let us go and put some social navigation bar also. So you go to appearance, you go to customize. You go to this section. And you go to this.
You add, and I guess you have. You go to menus. First, you discuss the primary menu, the main menu, the navigation menu, and theme also allows you to put a social media menu where we can put the our various social addresses links. So if the user clicks on that, the customer clicks on that, reaches to our Facebook page or Twitter page or whatever pages we have made on the social network. So what we do is we go to the social menu, we add an item. Over here there will be these categories, and we go to the custom link and we put a link address. So I've already put the Facebook. Why don't somebody gives me any URL as a landing page? Link test, you write Twitter. You would see once you log onto the site. Here it is. The Twitter link. The Facebook link was earlier there. Now the Twitter has also come. And this way you can put various links. Alright, we haven't made it so far, but I can just let you know how what is this static forefront page means. In this theme, it allows you also to put two things. A, all the pages like about us pages, contact us pages and all that as static page. And you can also do is you can just make one page as a blogging page. So if somebody clicks on that, they can have various blogs into it. So front page and front page is basically a home page, and this post page is where you can put different blogs into it. So if I select any of this page, let's say this page as a blog page, it will have all the blogs under it, since it cannot have because it was already a contact page and all that. So I'm not selecting that. So what we have to do is we have to make a page with the name blog, and then we have to correct it from here. I'll try to do it. Wait. So you go to pages, you add a new page with the name, let's say articles or blog, let's say I write blogs. I publish it. And then I go to appearance, customize. Static front page, blogs, publish. But I guess it also has to be put into the navigation bar that we haven't done. So what we do is we go to menus, Add item, we add pages, and we add block page. And see. And you could see that the weighted blog has come. Hello world, and this bring me and the latest blog which I put. So our website is now is a combination of different pages, like about us page, contact us page, we change the color, we change the header. And we have one section called blogs where we have different blogs into it. So we have one page with the blog and the other pages how we design it. Sangeeta has asked a question, what should be the page attribute for blog page? Wait, where have you seen the section page attribute? I have to go to page and then create it, right? Yeah, so Chirag is right. Basically, any attribute will have the content of putting it as a tagline. So you can just write an attribute about it. You can have parent page and sub page wala thing, but this particular thing which we have done is, see, you are writing down blogs and the blogs are going somewhere. It is right now under the widget section. So if you could see over here, this theme has main aspects of dividing the pages into two sections. One, it will have the basic attribute of the pages, and it will have its widget section, which is this. So in widget section, your blogs will initially your blogs will have uncategorized thing, and then you categorize into one section. But you also want a page on the navigation bar, let's say, where your blogs are, you know, pointed to that one particular page. So you're all, if somebody want to read the blog, can just click onto the blogs and do it. So this is what we have done. We have made different pages and we have made one blog page. So it allows us to put to go to this particular section where you static you decide your how your front page is going to look like. So you put a home page into it and you also put a post page into it. Since our this theme has two main attributes, one is blogging, the other is main pages, right? By default, it was showing parent page. Yes, it will be. So all clear till here. I guess we also are done with the time, but we have learned how to make the basic website and all. Next time we'll do search engine optimization of this site. This is how we'll learn how to do a search engine optimization, and we'll also try to pick, let's say, if in case we have the time, but with SEO probably will not be having a time, but if we have the time we'll start with the e-commerce thing, otherwise we'll do it on the further coming section. So everybody clear till here? Mukesh, NK, Sangeeta, Shubham, Subin, Ashen, Chitranshi. Alright, any questions? Live chat will be installed through a plugin. So see how a website is or how it goes is it, a theme will give you basic contents of how to make a website. For any additional top ups like putting a live chat or putting any additional feature, there will be various, no, there will be free live chat plugins available. There are basically many free, good free plugins available. Don't worry, what you have to do is just we'll pick up the plugins also. What, why I have skipped plugins right now is because once we do an SEO, we'll do it through a plugin. So next time when we are anyways gonna do a plugin and SEO, so I will also try to pick different plugins. So what you do is you go to a plugin and you add a plugin, and this is how you select plugins. So you can have live chat kind of feature or an SEO plugin or different plugins. So there are different plugins you can select. And there is no limitation. Even I, as a website development company, can make a different plugin for it and keep on, you know, pushing it onto the WordPress. So you just need, it is like a Google Play Store or an Android Play Store or an iPhone Play Store. It is just like that. So you'll get, you will be getting different products into it, and it'll be up to you. You want to buy it or you don't want to buy it. So when you ask me what a tag means, tag is basically tag in one way. You can define any tag as a one word summary for the content. So it is like a name. It is like in one word, if you want to represent any article, any blog or anything with one thing, with one word. So if somebody looks for that one word, is looking for that one thing, will connect it to you. It's like a tag. So you tag like you do in Facebook and all that, or you use a hashtag in Twitter. You're basically putting one word into this easy access for search engines to decide. So let's say I've written an article on sports, let's say on a cricket match. So I'll use a tag like cricket match, test match, India playing cricket, you know, Sachin Tendulkar, if it's playing Sachin Tendulkar. So I use these words, that one word, so that if somebody looks for it, click on that, the articles related to that tag comes. It is like a connecting window, right? Alright. Plugin, Sangeeta, is the additional features kind of thing. Because once you make a website, especially using a CMS, you get a basic theme. You pick up one theme. Everything will not have all the features which you want. Let's say I want a website for my new business tomorrow. I'm looking for different kind of feature. I want a live chat into it. I want this, I want that. But the themes which are available in front of me may not have that kind of plugin. So what I do is I buy a theme, and whatever is missing into that, I'll keep on buying it from plugins. Even time keeps on changing. Live chat was not available 5 years back. So whosoever, and the same way, if you made a website today and tomorrow a new feature comes, which is an easy feature, and you want it to be onto the website, you need not to scrap the whole website and then remake a website again and again. So plugins are the new feature which keeps on adding into the marketplace. And there are a few free plugins, there are a few buying which you can buy it. So you can just keep on buying it and installing it in your website. Yeah. So that are called plugins. You just plug that into your website. Got it, Sangeeta? How many video DMTs are showing on your ID? Shubham, I just do not keep a track of how many videos DMT shows from my ID, from any other ID. I'll tell you very clearly, I am only a trainer over here. So what I do is I just train you guys. I send us this session to the admin of DMP. They upload it and they have the responsibility of sharing what video to whom. So I just do not keep a track. I've never visited of what videos are there or not. You can just go and check it out. If in case you don't find anything, then just contact the admin, Nick Patla, and had a word with him. Are we here to give any exam for the certificates? I'm not sure. The certificates which DMP provides, I guess you probably will not be giving any exams. For additional certificates from the companies itself, probably you have to, but not from DMP, I suppose. But I'm not very sure. Again, the same is related to an admin-based question. Nick Batla is the concerned person. I'll share his number with you. Probably you will be having it. But I'll share it again. Anyhow. This is his number. His number is 9999 57235. Is Nick Rasla. So you can just contact him for the admin thing. Yes, Sangeeta. For SEO, we have a plugin. We'll just go to that plugin and it will be installed into our website panel, the admin panel, and then we'll do a SEO. We'll see you once we do tomorrow. You'll get to know, or on the next session, you'll get to know how we do it. Any more questions? No. The plugin which you'll be using is the most prominent plugin freely available. Even I could say that 90 to 95% of people use that plugin for SEO. So it's free, nothing. Let's keep some surprises. Any more questions? Any query? Yes, of course, Shubin, you'll get that. By somehow, the last session could have missed to be uploaded somehow. But I'll convey this to the admin that it should be uploaded. Once it's uploaded, you'll get to see it. Any more questions? So how did you find of making this or this session, making the website and all? Sangeeta is asking whether I would be out on 24, will you cover SEO? Don't worry, Sangeeta, we'll cover SEO in the next session only. The next will be on 10th, 17th. So we'll be covering SEO on 17th. And I was just kidding, on a lighter note, the plugin's name is Yoast, YO. AST Yoast SEO. So it is one of the most prominent plugins that we'll be using. But I will recommend you to take this session of SEO because that's very important. Yes. Any other query? Any more questions, or shall we call off the session today? Oh yes, Mukesh. Can you just resend it, please? Oh sure, you can call me. Anybody can call me, and also WhatsApp me. Why don't you guys just WhatsApp me? I'll add you to the group, which was made for this course. So I'll add you into the group and just give me a stinker on our website, on our WhatsApp. I'm sharing my details again. This is my number. This is my email ID. Mukesh, please share it again. I've just missed it because it was. Wait, I've got it. What is the name of the website, Mukesh? All right. But it is opening, there is no error coming. Yes, coming. How did you make this website? I mean, it was powered by WordPress. It was given by DMP only. Mukesh, was this website Chirag ASL? How's that? Mukesh, this website which you're trying to make, was it given to you by DMP or you're making it? I'm saying the website is coming good right now. Which file format is required? CSV itself is a Chirag is a file format. It is the derivative of Excel file. So what you have to do is you have to make the list of the email IDs on an Excel sheet, and then just go to file, save, and convert. Yes, comma separated. And you just go to file save as and save it in a CSV format. Okay, that I don't know, frankly. I'm not aware about it, how many types of CSV files are there. I guess I need to educate myself in for this. No, I'm saying I have no clue, but I'll educate myself on how many types of CSV files are there. It's okay. No, I think you have to make it on a list wise thing. I mean, one cell below other. So one information over other information. And then save it onto a CSV format. Any other query, friends? I guess it's time to go now. All right, friends, bye. See you in next session then.